on Trojans Live, a busy day here in Troy on this beautiful USC campus. Jordan Moore, Sean Cody, Max Brown, joined now by Donte Williams, the new interim head coach as of today. Donte obviously has been here for a little while now, coaching the cornerbacks and associate head coach, a big role within the team. But Donte, welcome to the show in this capacity. Obviously, I'm sure a whirlwind day for you. What was your sort of reaction and feeling as the day went on?
To be honest, I found out right before the team meeting. So, you know, waking up and everything else going through the day, it was just a normal day for me. You know, I was just getting, make sure my guys is ready to play and, you know, get ready for practice. And next thing you know, right before the team meeting, you know, Mike and Brandon pulled me in and talked to me. And, you know, pretty much, to be honest, you know, with those two and Dr. Folk gave me the opportunity of a lifetime. And, you know, since then, it's pretty much been nonstop since the team meeting and, you know, got a chance to pretty much have my first practice out here with the guys as, you know, the interim head coach. And, you know, I'm just taking it one step at a time right now.
Coach, a lot of transition here. You got to talk to your guys and, you know, after a tough loss, you guys didn't play well on Saturday. What's your first message to your guys when you get to talk to them?
Right now it's already, the season's started. You know, we have a lot of games left, but the season has started. It's hard to make, you know, I guess, huge changes right now. So my biggest thing is about enhancing everything we do. How can we enhance everything we do? Whether it's the way we lift weights, the way we eat, the way we practice, the way we play, just enhancing everything we do, you know, and that's the biggest message right now, making sure that we pretty much take care of all the little things, because too many little things become huge and big things, right? And they cost us. They cost us penalties. They cost us dumb mistakes. They cost us as a team. They cost us as a university, right? And that's the biggest message that I have, making sure that we enhance everything we do. Everyone in this organization needs to do something, you know, a little bit better than what they were doing before, including myself.
Coach, you know, when I was here in 2013 and 2015, one of the hardest parts was just the emotional wear of this, and it nets out differently with different guys, and obviously players have invested their USC career towards Clay Helton and towards his vision, and a lot of guys are probably hurt right now back at their apartments. How do you lift this team up emotionally right now with so many games left in the season?
I'm a person that's very fortunate because a lot of these guys either I've recruited here or I've recruited at past places. So I believe I have a great relationship with the guys on our team. I have a great relationship with the staff we have in place here. And, you know, a lot of these guys' families I even know pretty well. So I think, you know, the change that is happening right now, it's a lot easier for me than maybe it would be for someone else. So, you know, a lot of guys are hurt. You know, I'm really grateful for the opportunity that Clay even gave me, you know, a chance to come to USC. And, you know, I'm greatly appreciated of, you know, the opportunity that he gave me. And right now it's time for us, you know, like I say, as a university, as a team, as a whole organization to pull tighter together. And, you know, we still have the same message. You know, everybody says about going 1-0 in the game. I'm more on the facet of going 1-0 every day. And if we go 1-0 every day and we do the best that we can do every day individually and we do it in the organization as a team, then we're going to love the results that we get.
You're listening to Donte Williams, the interim head coach now for USC football here on Trojans Live. And, you know, Donte, Mike Bone talked about it pretty eloquently about how important bringing the fans back into this program as a positive force, especially when you're inside the Coliseum. What's your message to them as you will have lots of home games and a long season ahead to sort of do this as one?
I mean, to be honest, are you kidding me? Did you see the intro for that last game?
You guys were fired up.
It was hype. The intro, the student section, I mean, the atmosphere this past game was electric. So it's based on us and the product we put on the field to make sure that environment stays that way and gets even better, right? I'm about making sure the Coliseum is sold out. And what we need to do is make sure we put the best product on the field to make sure that happens, right? The administration here is doing everything possible to give us the things that we need to do to succeed, you know, and we're going to make sure that we put our best foot forward and we match their efforts, and we will.
Coach, you talked a little bit about what you want to do off the field. Hey, everyone get a little bit, enhance something, get a little bit better at something. Obviously, Saturday wasn't pretty. What needs to be fixed on the field right now for USC to have a better game on Saturday?
To not have the stupid mistakes, right? And play more together as a family, as a team. Like, everyone says those words, but at the same time, you have to be able to live by those words. And when you do stupid things that cost the team, you're not protecting your family, right? And we have to be strong enough to be able to get on one another, right, and appreciate the person next to you that they're getting on you because they care about you. And we got to pull the next man with us. And that's on all facets of the game, right? That's all the coaches, the way we coach. That's the players, the way they play. We have to all be held accountable for the things that we're doing. So one thing we have to do, we have to eliminate the dumb mistakes. And once we eliminate the dumb mistakes, you're going to see true Trojan football.
Coach, how does your role change on game day? Obviously, you're used to just having your one cohesive room. Now you got a lot more bodies to manage. How does it change for you day to day?
To be honest, it changes a lot on game day because coming to USC was the first time I've ever been in the box, right? And I'm grateful for the opportunity. But at the same time, I love being on the field. I love being around the guys. I love, you know, hyping those guys up and being fully involved. You know, it's nothing like seeing a player dead in his eyes of what's going on, right? Because I don't believe in just because a person makes a mistake, you just yank them out. Mm-hmm. If all of a sudden you take them out the game and you look in their eyes and they made a mistake and they look shell-shocked or look like, you know, a lost dog or something like that, then you need to take that
mouse stare.
Correct. But if they look at you like, you know, I know what I did, I'm ready to go back in, I'm ready to dominate, that you can't see that in the box. I see those things on the sideline. So just being more involved, and it's not just now defense, it's me being involved in the decisions that we make that can help our whole team make sure we, you know, be 1-0.
That is Donte Williams. He is looking to go 1-0 this week as he makes his interim head coaching debut on Saturday up in Pullman against Washington State. We'll have that for you right here. 12:30 kickoff on Saturday, and then we'll talk to Coach next week on Trojans Live. Thank you, Donte, and a whole busy day for you. Appreciate you spending some time with us. Hey, Trojan fans, get ready for game day with the Ralph's app. Enjoy free delivery with a delivery savings pass, and then save on your fresh tailgating faves. Ralph's is a proud partner of USC Athletics. Fight on. Restrictions apply. We come back. John Jackson's going to join us, and we'll just sort of go over a little reaction, breather, take it all in, a little perspective on what we have seen and heard today. Back with more on Trojans Live.
Trojan fans, we understand it can be overwhelming to face the uncertainty.